Hi, my name is Dee. In this video, you'll learn how to import your offering setup. You need the Application Implementation Consultant role to perform this activity. Before you can import, you must first export your offering setup as described in the Export Offering Setup tutorial. To start, go to Offering Setup. You've successfully exported the setup data of Supply Chain Planning, and now you're ready to import it to another environment. Create a new import process. If you export setup data of an entire offering, you start the import process from the offering. Next, select the configuration package file that contains the exported setup data that you want to import. The Configuration Package Details section shows the basic information about the exported file so you can verify whether or not you have selected the correct file. If you need to, you can use the Update button to select a different file, but this looks great. Although Feature Selection, that is, the opt-in configuration, is exported along with the setup data, it's not automatically imported. If you want to import opt-in configuration, you have to explicitly select the Import Feature Selection checkbox and then submit. When you choose to import the opt-in configuration, a warning is displayed that the import will override the opt-in configuration of the current environment. Confirm that this is what you want to do. If any setup of the offering requires that the data be entered manually before import can start, a warning is displayed showing the tasks that you must perform before resuming the import process. These are the same manual tasks that you received a warning about at the end of the export processing. Ensure that you've entered this setup data and then select Resume. Once you resume the import process, you receive a confirmation. The status of the import process is displayed on the setup page. Continue to watch the process until it completes. If any setup requires manual data entry during import, the process pauses and the status shows waiting for manual import. Drill down to review what you have to enter manually. Here, you'll see that you have to grant user access to the reference data sets manually. So, go to the appropriate page to enter the data, drill down on the task name, and once you complete your data entry, return to the import process page and resume the import process. Confirm that you want to continue. The import process resumes. Now watch the process until it completes. Review the summary of the process. The process was successful. Now review if there are any manual tasks that you need to complete. If so, ensure that they're correctly performed. Otherwise, the offering will not be fully ready to be used. If the import process completes with errors, under the Business Objects section, the Status Details column displays the error details, in which case you'd review and take appropriate action to correct the errors. Since this process completed successfully, you do not need to take any additional actions. However, it is a best practice to verify correct data was imported for the setup objects. You can verify data before making the offering available to users. If you exported setup data of a functional area instead of an entire offering, you start the import process from the functional area. For example, after your initial import of the entire offering, if you need to migrate setup changes for Enterprise Profile, you could export only that functional area. In that case, select Enterprise Profile from the list of functional areas and then create a new import process. The rest of the import process works the same for both the offering and the functional areas. Thanks for watching!